Hello, everyone. So today I wrote my first letter to the editor. I went on the website assangedefense.org and I read the instructions on taking part in this campaign to basically free Assange, finally. His health is deteriorating. It's pretty bad, his health, and we must act now to save his life. I really believe that this can be a turning point in human history, and we can show that we have the moral fitness to survive. It's not everything. There's a lot more that we need to do. But freeing Assange is a good start to make the world a much better place. I will read you the letter I wrote to the Ottawa Citizen. It's at sent to letters@ottawacitizen.com. So here goes. The case of Julian Assange's persecution has assembled the greatest legal defense team in history. And even while this is so, until recently, the media was essentially silent and passive on the case, or complicit. Faced with a complete assessment of the case, one cannot and should not remain indifferent, as it becomes obvious that the abuse of Julian's rights and the threat to his life is not only affecting this one individual. This unjust persecution affects us all, whether we realize it or not. To the extent we tolerate the present abuses, we are all being sent the message to shut up and to submit to powerful players. It is our rights and our lives which are being attacked. The U.S. government is grasping at straws, as demonstrated by its desperate use of the Espionage Act to deny Julian, an Australian citizen, read, not an American, his rights and liberties. Stella Morris, Julian's wife, mother of his children, and one of his many lawyers, says Julian cannot get a fair trial in America because he is being prosecuted under the Espionage Act, and he cannot bring a public interest defense. He cannot say, I published this information because it was in the public interest, precisely because it is under the Espionage Act. And it is the first time that a publisher has ever been published, that a publisher has ever been prosecuted under this act, something that constitutional lawyers in the United States have been warning could happen for the past 50 years. In the documentary Ithaca, Julian's father, John Shipton, speaking to the media assembled around him in London, England, he says, nobody ever again will be able to get the assistance of 100,000 people worldwide to defend them. 100 lawyers, 6 jurisdictions in order to defend Julian Assange. It'll never happen again. If he goes down, so will journalism. For all the people, for all the journalists around the world, this is the time to speak up in his defense. We cannot continue to stand idly by with so much at stake. Join us in speaking truth to power. The November 28th open letter from the New York Times and four other major international outlets, namely Le Monde, El Pais, Der Spiegel, and The Guardian, has recently made major waves in the media. The time is right for us to push for all media outlets to speak up and to get on the record. Publishing is not a crime. At this time of humanity's existential crisis, faced with a new world war, wouldn't it send a powerful and hopeful message to the world if we were to unite our voices together for a just cause? How do we choose to answer the question as to whether humanity has the moral fitness to survive? Do we?